The piano starts on C from your left, and it ends on B on your right. C, it's the piano's right, and your left behind. We never ask too much, but we are reminded we are to give generously, and we should be excited, not readily give, but to give with a cheerful heart. We grow dependent upon God as we grow closer when we give Him our life and our belongings. Even if there is fear in our hearts, we should show the gratitude and obedience that we want to be. Even if we set aside our comfort zones and reach out to the kingdom grows, as does our relationship with our Father and those that are around us. What a blessing it is to truly have something to give, something that we can offer to God, to our fellow brothers and sisters, the symbol of our trust and the covenant and the faithfulness of our dear Father. In thanksgiving, we pour forth our belongings, our time, our resources. This is not done in vain. Paul reminds us we'll be rewarded. He is a God of promise. Measures are not myths or things that go unreachable or something that's untamed. Rather, they are fortified by the whole of our Christian truths that have been proven throughout history, and our giving is that proof. Being part of the gracious giving can give a sense of accomplishment and humbleness that is worth much more than the little we have to offer. It's a way to connect with those in need and a means to build a bridge towards an eternity that we humans have always sought. As we open our hearts, our finances, our relations, our lives to the Creator, we gain in so many ways. I can imagine God watching our steps in gracious giving, accepting whatever we have to give, and giving us the trust to build upon the small increments we started with. It seems all started with nothing. The power of giving goes on and on. As the kingdom grows, we reach farther, and our brothers and sisters are rewarded instead of punished by their stuff and see what it gives you. Emptiness and wanting more. Buy their stuff and see what it gives you. Give it away or help. Isn't a smile worth more than a plasma TV? Isn't the power of God more and the Super Bowl brings? We should help our children, for charity starts at home. And we should help our brothers and sisters, and even our enemies. I have personally seen the eyes of desperate turn to joy as I have buttered or offered a little dollar or something to get them started. How many bridges have been built by giving graciously to those in need? Lives are changed by our little acts of trust. Lives are changed by our little acts of trust. Trust what you know, and you won't get what you get. But if you reach out, so you will receive a gift. God has often given us everything we always need. Nothing we can get here on this earth really belongs to you or me. It's just stuff we borrow, things we need to live. Why can't we give Him what we want? It's not that much payment. It's really not that much payment. Really not that much. What can you give? We could always use prayer. Not many people like a crying baby. As young parents, we have to learn how to stifle the cries. As gracious givers, we have to learn what the world needs.